This tutorial shows the calculation of the effect size following a significant Mann-Whitney-Wilcoxon test in SPSS. Unfortunately, SPSS does not calculate an effect size for you. However, to calculate the effect size R, a simple division is sufficient. For R, you need to divide the absolute value of the standardized test statistic Z by the square root of the number of observations. When we look closely in the second table, you can spot both, total N being the number of observations and the standardized test statistic right above the significance. In my example, I have to divide 2.204 by the square root of 51. I can either do that in Excel, Google Sheets, or use the calculator. If you want the calculation to be as exact as possible, I would recommend using Excel or Google Sheets and copy the standardized test statistic with all decimals available and do the calculation there. In my example, the resulting effect size R has a value of 0.309 rounded to 3 decimals. Finally, you need to classify the magnitude of this effect. If similar studies in your research field exist, compare your effect size with the given one. If no comparable study exists, use the common thresholds within your research fields. If those are also non-existent, you can refer to Cohen 92 A power primer. Page 157 shows three thresholds for the effect size R: 0.1, 0.3 and 0.5 for small, medium and large effects. In my example, 0.309 is above the threshold for a medium effect if I use Cohen's thresholds. When you're done, you have to write up the results. The video that appears now will show you how.